Welcome children to chapter 3 weather and climate. Alright, so in social studies whenever we listen to weather and climate, what do we understand by it? Right, these are two terms which sound the same but of course have very different meaning. In this chapter let us read and understand what the meanings are and how they differ from each other and what kind of influence it has in the environment. How do we introduce weather as? Weather is a temporary phenomena. It changes every day. It may change even during the same day. Sometimes a sunny weather in the morning turns cloudy or windy in the evening. So children, what do we understand by this is that the weather changes every now and then. It is not stable for a very long duration, right? Every day we watch the weather report on TV or read the weather forecast in the newspaper and plan our clothing and activities accordingly. If there is a forecast of rain or thunder shower and you have to go out, what preparations would you take? Right now you have to think to yourself, what would you actually do when you get to hear a weather forecast? Right, when you get to know about rain or thunder shower, you definitely will go out with your raincoat or an umbrella, right, or whatever the preparations that you want to. Thus, how can we define weather? Weather is the condition of atmosphere at a particular place on a particular day or time. The condition of air, temperature, wind, humidity and rainfall at a particular time determines the weather of that place. Alright, so for that particular moment, for that particular time period, these are the things, okay, and what are the things? The air, temperature, wind, humidity, etc., etc., they determine the weather of that particular place. Okay, moving forward, the weather is the sum total, the climate is the sum total of the weather at a place over a very long period of time. So, what is climate? When it is there at a particular place for a very long period of time, that is called climate. The weather of a place may keep changing, but the climate of a place remains more or less the same for years and years, right? That is how we determine the climate of a particular place, children. When we talk about a certain place like Kullu Manali, we say, oh my god, this place has a very cold climate, right, throughout the year, which means it does not change every now and then, right? The frequency of the temperature, okay, or the weather is for a very long period, right? So that determines the climate of that particular place. Weather data collected over several decades are used to make climate graphs. Now, we have certain factors which influence the climate. What are the factors influencing the climate, children? Let us go ahead and understand. So, the first factor that influence the climate are distance from the equator. Now, see children, how your latitudes and longitudes that we had learned in chapter number 2 plays a very great role in determining the climate or the weather of the particular place. Like we said, distance from equator. Now, equator is going to decide, right, the kind of climate that particular place would have. The climate of a place is greatly influenced by its distance from the equator, right? How far or how near. The places near the equator are hotter because the rays of the sun fall vertically on the equator. Means it falls straight on the equator. It is not slanting, right? It is not sleeping, nothing but absolutely straight. So we call it vertically on the equator. Since the vertical rays covers a smaller area, they are more concentrated. What do we understand by concentrated, children, here? Concentrated means it does not spread anywhere, right? When it is falling vertically, it is limited only to that particular place, doesn't spread anywhere, okay? That is why it is hot at the equator. Now, as we move away from the equator towards the poles, alright, towards the poles, what are the poles? North pole and the south pole. The rays of the sun become slanting. and spread over a larger area. Now see how it is spreading over a larger area. When it is slanting, of course it reaches and it covers a larger area, right? So that is what is being told here. This means that the heat is less concentrated, so it is cooler, means it is getting enough space to cool down in between, okay, because it is getting spread over a larger area. The polar regions, what are the polar regions? Again, the regions near the poles, that is the south and the north pole, alright. Being farthest from the equator experiences extremely cold climate. So what is happening, children? The rays, the sun rays which is falling in the polar regions are all the more slanting, alright. Means it is almost nil, not reaching the ground, not reaching the earth, okay. That is why very less heat is experienced there, okay, and mostly it is cold. You see, there are times when the sunlight does not even reach the ground, alright. So for now, children, we will be learning only this first factor that influences the climate. In the next session, we'll be doing the rest. Thank you.